Hello and welcome to Method Tutorials. Today we're looking at importing customer leads. When leads are imported, they go into Method, but they are not synced with QuickBooks because they are leads. Ready to get started? The first thing you need is a spreadsheet file with your list of leads and their information. However, this must be properly formatted in order for the import to work. So, we have something for you. Template files you can download. There are two files to make your life easier. One for those on QuickBooks Desktop and the other for those on QuickBooks Online. You can find these files on our Help Center or you can download it right here, right now. Choose one for you. In this video, we're going to choose QuickBooks Online, but don't worry, the differences are minimal and the process is the same. Once you download it, you will find that it's an Excel file. As you can see, we have a lot of column headers. We have put comments on those headers to give you more information, and we also included sample data. Obviously, delete the sample data before you import this file. Note, we didn't include all the column headers because that would be overwhelming. The ones in this template are just the common fields. You can, however, add additional fields from the table if needed. Maybe I want to include a fax field for those of you who still use fax. Anyway, another thing, you don't have to fill out every column. Heck, all of them can stay blank except for the required fields. In QuickBooks Desktop, there is only one required field, the name field. In QuickBooks Online, there are two required fields, name field and the first name field. I've highlighted it in green here. Make sure these required fields have values. One last thing, these column headers are the proper field names. We recommend keeping them as is. However, if you wish to change them, you will have to manually map them during the import. Once you delete the sample data and put in your lead information, you will need to export it as a CSV file. Remember where you're going to save it, because now we're going to the import. I've saved my CSV file on my desktop. Now to go to my browser and log into Method. Here I am, and I will select the vertical ellipsis button on the Contacts app, and then select Import from the menu. And this takes you to the Import Contact screen. Ooh, look, it's this video now playing in this video. That's crazy. Anyway, continuing on, click one of the import links. This will open up a separate browser page and take you to step number one, Import Export menu. Okay, for number one, we will choose import into a table from a file. Number two will give you a list of options. And here I emphasize choose customer lead table. We're importing leads, don't choose anything else. And now number three, file to import. I've cleverly named my import file importleads.csv, so open it up. And we're ready to go. For number four, click import data. This will take us to step two, prepare data. Wow, fun times. Down here at number three, we select the columns to import. As you can see, it's telling us which column in our import spreadsheet is being imported into which existing field in the customer table. For each column, I can choose a different field to import to, or I can even choose not to import that column at all. However, I'm going to keep it at the default and go click import data. We're on to step three, validation. Let's begin the import. Go, go, gadget, import. Huzzah, successfully imported. I'm done. Did the import work? Yes, of course it did, but I'm going to check anyway. Let's go back to Method and into our Contacts app so I can find the leads I imported. I want to list the leads, so let me change the filter to shared active leads. And there they all are, the ones I imported. Ha ha! Thank you for watching Importing Customer Leads. If you have any questions, leave a comment on YouTube. Check out our documentation, post on our forums, or you can tweet us at MethodCRM. Thanks for watching, and have a great day. Bye-bye!